Hi guys, my name is Vivek and today I'll be explaining you the difference between row level and column level storage. So the way the data is stored in the database is slightly different and it depends upon what kind of functionality you want to achieve with the database. So we will understand that which database should be used in which condition over the next few minutes. So let's understand this concept with the help of a simple table employee. So we have 5 columns in employee table: employee ID, name, location, salary and unit, and for the simplicity of understanding we have taken only 5 rows. So how the data will be stored in a row level storage database like Oracle? In a row level storage database like Oracle, we will have each row stored separately. That means a particular row will have all the columns stored together in a different location. So we will have the first row stored in a separate place, then we will have the second row and so on. So in case if you are running a query like select all from employee, it will pick the data from the first row, then the second row and so on. Now let's consider an example. We want to select 2 columns from employee table. So in an ideal world, if you are running a query select name salary from employee, only 2 columns should be selected, that is name and salary. But that is not how the row level storage works. In the row level storage, since I mentioned that all the columns of a particular row are stored together, it will access all the columns for that particular row, though we only want 2 columns. So first the first row will be accessed, then it will go on accessing the entire second row and third row. The challenge with this is that we are accessing additional columns which are not even required for our functionality, and since we are accessing these columns, our performance will be slow because we will be reading more data from the disk. Though for 5 rows or 5 columns this may not seems like a big issue, but let's take a real business scenario. Suppose we have an employee table which has 5 lakh rows and 100 columns. Let's say the varchar size is 100 bytes for each column. So let's find out how much time it will take to run this query where we are selecting 2 columns from the employee table. So if you see, we are accessing 5 lakh rows each having 100 column and the size of column is 0.1 KB. So we have converted the entire thing in KBs, so we want to convert the disk reading speed also in KB. So we are having 100 into 1000, which is approximate. So this is our disk reading speed and this is the amount of data that we want. This is the amount of data that we want to read and this is the disk reading speed. So to execute this query and retrieve the entire results, it will take around 50 seconds, which is on the higher side to access 5 lakh rows. Now let's understand how the data is stored in a column level storage and how different will be the output of the query for the same business scenario in a column level storage database. So here, as you see, we have each column stored as a different file. This is entirely different from a row level database, because in a row level database we had all the columns of a particular row binded together and are stored at a particular location. But in column level storage, we have the entire column stored as a separate file. So we have employee ID as one file, name as another, location as another, and so on. So in case if you want to run the same query, select name and salary from employee, this is the ideal environment for such a query, since we have to access only 2 columns, and in column level storage, we'll end up accessing only those 2 columns. Let's understand for the same business scenario how much time it will take to execute this query. We have the same 5 lakh rows, each row has 100 column and the same varchar size as 100 bytes. Even the disk reading speed we have considered the same. So that particular query, the change is that instead of accessing 100 columns, now we will be accessing only 2 columns. That means the performance has increased by 50 times. Now the question arises, if column level storage is 50 times faster than row level storage, why do we need row level storage at all? So let's go over this query, select all from employee. Now here we are accessing all the columns of the employee table. The challenge is, if you see here, all the columns are stored in a different file. So let's take the example of the first row. First of all, we will have to access employee ID 1 from one file, then we'll access its corresponding name Vivek from the second file, the location from the third file, and so on. That means we will have to access multiple files, which will be an additional overhead and result in deterioration of performance. So it entirely depends what kind of use case you want to implement in your application, and based on that you can decide whether you want to go over a column level storage or a row level storage. For example, if you are having a transactional system where majority of the columns are required or all columns are required while you are retrieving data, it is obvious that you should go for a row level storage database like Oracle, or for an operational data store where you have to join multiple columns or multiple more columns or retrieve more columns. In that case, you should always go for a row level storage. While in case if you are having a data mart or a data warehouse which you are using for analytical reporting, or where you have aggregated data where you are computing too much of aggregated data, like let me give you an example. If I am a manager and I want to see that a particular product of my company, how much sale it had for a particular product in a particular region for this particular month. If I have such kind of data stored in my table, I would, that requires fast computation and computation on a particular column. So that means I would prefer a column level storage database like Vertica, where computation is required only on several columns. So it entirely depends upon your use case whether you should opt for row level storage or column level storage. In case if you want to learn further the precise differences between these two or their further implementation cases, or want to learn these two, the row level technology and the column level database technology, you can drop us a note on www.internshipsfromhome.com. You can also write a note on reachtechcoach@gmail.com, and we will be happy to help you with more videos. Thanks for watching this video.